the lesson that we are going to do today. And what is the best way to do that? Right, none other than our meditation, right? Because it makes your mind fresh and ready for learning. So I want everyone to sit with their back straight, eyes closed, and just concentrate on your breathing. Just breathe in and breathe out. Breathe in, breathe out. Slowly open your eyes. Very nice, children. Rub your palm. Place it on your eyes. Rub it on your face, neck, shoulder, and back on your legs. Now, you all know that whenever we start a lesson, the teacher always has some or the other surprise for you, right? Now, last time also we had a box full of surprises. And you know what was there in that box? Right. There were too many rhyming words. Now, you know, my mama used to play this game every time with me. A box of surprises. And whenever I used to open that box and I used to take out the objects from that box, it not only used to be a fun, but it also taught me so many things. So why not try this right now in our classroom with you children, right? Now, mama, teacher is going to remove, like mama, a few things from the boxes, and the game is that you have to tell me that whatever object I remove from the box, what comes to your mind when you see that particular object? Anything that comes to your mind, you're going to raise your hand and answer. Now, right now, this is not our normal classroom. The teacher can't see everyone and teacher cannot say, okay, you answer. So just wait for your turn, or you can also type your answers in the chat box. But right now, everyone is going to just pay attention and look at what teacher is showing one by one from her box of goodies. What is there? Yes. What I have found, the first thing is a kite. Is this a kite? Now, when we see a kite, what comes to our mind, the first thing? Yes, we all love kite flying. And when do we see the maximum number of kites in the fly? Correct, during the Makar Sankranti festival or the kite festival. Very good answer. So, let us see the other things in the box, because I know you all are very smart and you are going to recognize it very fast. Oh my God, what is this? What comes to your mind when you see this? Yes, the festival which is just going to come round the corner. You love to burst crackers, right? Even I used to love when I was very small. So this is the fountain which we burst the cracker. And you know, I have got some more crackers. But I am very much scared of these crackers. There is one more cracker in my box. But these crackers have to be used very carefully. And how, teacher will explain you later. So very good children, 2-on-2. So the first thing was a kite, which reminded you of the kite flying festival. And the second one is a cracker, which you burst during the Bali festival. Very nice. Now, let me see what else I have. Oh, such a beautiful and big pitkari. Right? You all love using this? Correct? This reminds me of which festival? Yes, you're right. This reminds me of the Holi festival. You all love to put water on our friends through this beautiful pitkari. And yes, we also love to throw colors on our friends. My smart children, all 3-on-3 you have got correct. So it's going to be a very interesting thing now. Now something difficult I think I'll get for you. Anyone recognizes what is this? Anyone? Yes, yes. you can say the Hindi name also, because that is what we are using. Yes, these are the sona leaves, which as we call it in Hindi. Otherwise, these are the leaves which are used, which we give each other during the which festival? Correct, we give this during the Dasara festival. The actual name for this is Bahunia Rekimosa, which is a little difficult name for you, but yes, we can always remember it as Sona leaf, which we give as a good luck to each other during the Dasara festival. Little difficult now, but yes, my smart children, they have an answer for everything. Now, everyone's favorite. Oh, wow. I have got something very interesting. Ting tong. What does this remind us of? Correct. Jingle bell, jingle bell, jingle all the way. Christmas. Santa Claus comes ringing the bell. Correct. When he's ringing the bell and he comes and he brings so many goodies and gifts for all you kids. Now, we are grown-ups, we don't get the gifts, but yes, we love when you get those gifts from the Santa. Every year, school also Santa comes, no? With so many gifts. Now, right now, your Santa is your mom and dad. Because whatever you get, all the goodies and gifts you'll get from them only. Now, one last thing. Oh, yes. What is this beautiful piece of thread? Anyone recognize this? Correct. This is a rakhi. This is a rakhi which the sister ties on the wrist of the brother. So this reminds you of what? Correct. This reminds you of the rakhi. So all the objects which we saw just now in our boxes, they remind us of what was in common? Correct, children. These all things were related to the festivals, because festivals are a very important part of our life. So today we are going to learn a lesson on the festivals and their celebrations. How do we have festivals? How many festivals do we have and how do we celebrate those festivals? You know what? Our country, India, it is a land of festivals. We have got so many festivals. And you all love festivals. There may be so many reasons for it. I love festivals because in festivals we get so many things to, we have got so many activities to do. I can decorate my house. We get so many nice goodies to eat, so many nice eatables to eat. And yes, the festivals, correct. Nowadays, so we are bored of the holiday because we are sitting at home because of this pandemic. But otherwise, festival means, correct, festival means a holiday. So some of you must be liking festivals, eating for festivals so that you get a holiday on that particular day. So, as I said, our country India is a land of festivals. And you know, festival is a time to have a lot of fun and frolic. We all enjoy during festivals. And when we have so many festivals to enjoy in a country with so many states, so many cultures, so many traditions, then it's, every day is a festival for us. So today I'm going to teach you about various festivals that we have and the kinds of festivals that we have with the help of a presentation. First, you're going to see the presentation very carefully. And then in the end, like the beginning riddle, in the end also, we are going to play a game. So everyone, when I am presenting, everyone is going to pay attention. No one touches the screen. Correct. And no one tries to unmute himself or herself. So, we are learning today about the festivals of India. Let us see about the festivals. What are these festivals? And in what way they are significant for us? Why do we love the festivals? Now, as I said, as I've already written, India is sometimes known as the country of festivals because we are a secular country. Secular country means people of all various religions and linguistic differences. We all stay here together. And that is why we celebrate numerous festivals. And today we are going to learn more about them. India is a country of many people having different customs and traditions. You can see right from Kashmir till Kanyakumari, all the states that we have, all the states, the people are having different languages. We have got our different traditional way of clothing, different traditional food, and in the same way, different festivals. Festivals of different significance and importance for everyone. That is why we get to celebrate so many festivals here. Let us see what we have next. Now, because of the religions, we can see that festivals in India, we have got Hindu festivals celebrated by the Muslims, festivals which are celebrated by the Christians, the Sikh people, the Jain festivals, and the most important of all, the national festivals. Now, India being such a country of varied cultures, still there are certain festivals which are national festivals which we all celebrate together. So those festivals are known as national festivals. And each festival has its own importance. So one by one, we are going to see the importance of each and every festival. Children, please do not type anything unwanted in the chat box. You have to fold your hands and just pay attention. Now, one very important feature of we Indians is that we all live together in families, right? And we all love to be with our family. We all adore our family. Can you stay with your family? No. Even I cannot stay with my family. And you know that all the families are a part of a society. Society at large. Right? Now, because we are all living together in families and we all live in the society, in what way we are supposed to celebrate festivals? Why are we supposed to celebrate festivals is what I'm going to show you in the next slide. Yes, living together encourages the families to celebrate religious and national festivals. Can you celebrate a festival alone? No. For celebrating festivals, we always require some people with us. Either some festivals we can celebrate with our friends, like the kite flying. For that, we can enjoy having that with our friends. Holi, we can play with our friends. But most of the festivals we like to celebrate with our loved ones, with our families. That is why living together in a family is very important. Encourages all of us to celebrate the festivals, the religious as well as the national festivals, right? Because sabke saath hai. When all are together, when all life are celebrating the festival together, we all can have the fun together. That is why we have so many festivals, especially in our country. Next slide. Now, one by one, we learn about the different festivals, difference between the natural festivals and the religious festivals. Now, in the next slide, you can see one of your friends who is very much confused. Let us see what confusion he has. Oh, yes, festivals. What are festivals? And I have never heard of the types of festivals. Now, look at this boy. He does not know what festivals are. He must be enjoying all of them, but he does not know the significance of the festivals. And he has never heard that there are different types of festivals. So let us see who is going to come and help him. He must be having some friend who will come forward and help him. Oh, yes. We have our friend, very own. Billu, you can see Billu here. Yes, Billu has come. Oh, bale bale, you don't know about festivals? Wait, I will call my sister. She will explain us everything about festivals. Now, Billu knows about festivals, but he wants his friend to know in detail about the festivals. So, for that purpose, you know, the elders know much more than the small children. Na? You also know, but the elders know much. So, Billu is going to call his sister now. Let us see his sister and what all she has information for us. Come on, Billu. Call your sister fast. All my kids are waiting. Oh, here comes sister of Billu. Yes, Billu. I would love to tell you about these various festivals which enhance and exhibit our Indian culture and tradition. So, sister, Billu's elder sister is all ready. And as you can see, she has come immediately to tell Billu and his friends about the various festivals which enhance and exhibit the show our Indian culture and tradition. Now, let us see what all festivals Billu's sister has got to explain. All are excited, even my kids and myself. First, Billu's sister explains that the festival is a time of fun and frolic. And it is a time when we all have joy. We all celebrate. And India being a land of festivals, not a single month goes by without a festival. So, the moment we get the New Year's calendar, what is the first thing we see? We keep on searching what are the festivals, what are the days when we have festivals. Because there is not a single month in our country that goes without a festival. Now, so many friends of Billu have come. Only one boy had confusion, but when Didi started telling the story about festivals, so many friends came. And they all started asking first about the national festivals. That Didi, please tell us about the national festivals. And Didi, as you know, she is very smart. She has got answer for all. Now she will explain about the national festivals. Let us see what explanation she has. Sure, kids. She is ever ready to explain. Some festivals are of national importance and are celebrated by the whole nation. Such festivals are called as national festivals because they are important for all of us. We all have got some relation with that festival. That is why we all Indians celebrate that particular festival, and those festivals are called as national festivals. Let us see which are the national festivals which we celebrate. Now, these are the three very important national festivals which are celebrated by us. The Republic Day, Independence Day, and Gandhi Jayanti. This is all across the country by all the countrymen, all the Indians. Let's see one by one the significance of the festival. Let us see about Republic Day. The next slide. First is Independence Day. Now you all know that we celebrate Independence Day on which day? Yes, we celebrate it on the 15th August every year. Now you know that on this particular day, India got independence or freedom from the Britishers. You know those Britishers, they had come to our country and they ruled our country for so many years. And they gave us so much of trouble. But with the help of and because of the courage of our freedom fighters, we were finally successful in removing those Britishers from our country. And on this particular day, that is on the 15th of August 1947, we got freedom, we got independence from those Britishers. And that is why this day is celebrated every year as the Independence Day. Now, on this particular day, the Prime Minister, he hoists the national flag on the Red Fort. You can see the flag hoisting on the Red Fort, and he also gives a speech. And we also in the school, we celebrate this by hoisting the national flag. You know, you all come in the morning. Yes, and we all sing patriotic songs, we give speeches, and we remember all the freedom fighters who all have given their lives for us. Next slide, sir. Yes, it is the celebrated on 15th August. India became free in 1947 and our Prime Minister hoists the national flag at Red Fort in New Delhi. Now let us see about the Republic Day. Now Republic Day is celebrated on correct. It is celebrated on the 26th of January every year. Now, on this particular day, our India has built the constitution. Now, we got freedom. But after that, we all also had to know how the country has to run. For that, everyone has to be given some duties, some rights. So, for that, the constitution was designed. And on that particular day, that is 26th of January, 1950, our constitution was put into force, and that is why we celebrate that day as Republic Day every year. Now in this day, you know, there are so many colorful parades which are held at the Red Fort, and Prime Minister is there, who is there. And the Prime Minister, he hoists the flag. And we have got all the people. The next Next festival is the Gandhi Jayanti festival, which is a national very important celebration in our country. The next slide, sir. Next, sir. So Gandhi Jayanti celebrated on 2nd October. It is the birthday of Mahatma Gandhi, the father of our nation, and people visit Rajghat, that is, and we give homage or we pay homage to Mahatma Gandhi on this particular day. Now let us see the religious festivals. You know, these religious festivals are there are so many religious festivals like Makar Sankranti, Dasara, Diwali, Gurpurab, Mahavir Jayanti, Janmashtami, and one by one we are going to see about all these festivals, these colorful festivals of our nation. Let us see. Next, sir. Now, India being a land of various cultures, traditions. Sir, can we go to the next slide and we can make it a little faster? Am I audible? Let us finish the. Yes, let us see all these festivals one by one. Diwali, the most awaiting festival, which is going to be just round the corner. You know that Diwali, the moment we hear the term Diwali, all bright and shiny thing comes to our mind. Correct. Diwali is a festival of lights, and we all love to celebrate this festival. Mama makes beautiful rangolis in front of the houses, and we light our houses during the evening with the help of these decorative candles and diyas. And different types of sweets and different types of snacks are made by Mama at this particular time. We love to wear new clothes and visit our relatives. So Diwali is a festival which is also we mark as for worshipping the goddess Lakshmi. What's one thing we should remember in mind, that when we are celebrating Diwali, we should be very careful not to burst the crackers, which are not lot of crackers, because this will cause a lot of noise pollution. They are harmful for our ears. And old people and patients, yes, they get a lot of trouble because of this noise, and it also makes the air very dirty, the smoke that comes from the crackers. So as far as possible, we should use less amount of that. Next comes our Holi, that is the festival of colors. Now there is a lot of significance given to this Holi festival, and we celebrate it with lot of fun and frolic with beautiful different colors. Let us see what is the importance of Holi. And yes, later on, I am going to tell you a very that you should only use the herbal colors for playing Holi or the simple gulal that we have. Do not use the chemical mixed colors. Next comes the festival of Dasara. Now, Dasara is the festival which is celebrated after the 9 days of Navratri. On 9 days of Navratri, celebrated as Durga Puja. And after that, on 10th day, the effigy of Ravana is burned. Now, that is supposed to be the victory of the evil, the victory of the victory over the evil. The good people, they have victory over the evil people. So, the 10th day of Dasara is celebrated as Vijayadashmi or Dasara. And for 9 days, goddess Durga is worshipped. Okay, now let us see the next festival we have. Yes, our very own Ganpati Bappa Moriya, the Ganesh Chaturthi festival. Now, this festival is celebrated with a lot of pomp, lot of vigor, lot of enthusiasm all over the country, especially by the people of Maharashtra. And we all wait to call to bring our Ganesha home, and we worship him and we offer things to him, and we keep, and at the last day we immerse the idols of Ganesha in water. And nowadays, like this year, we all had eco-friendly Ganesha so that it does not pollute the water. So for that also we should see that we use eco-friendly Ganesh idols so that we can save our water from getting polluted. Let us see the next festival. Next, sir. Yes. Now, Eid al-Fitr is a festival celebrated by the Muslims. Now, after a whole month of fasting of Ramzan, the last day they fast during the daytime, they celebrate the festival of Eid, where they go to the mosque, they read the Holy Mass, and a special delicacy is made on that day. The people give gifts and they greet each other by hugging each other. So that is the festival of Eid al-Fitr, which is celebrated by the Muslims. People distribute money and clothes to the poor people on this particular day. So Eid al-Fitr and Eid al-Zuha are the two important Eid festivals which are celebrated by the Muslim people in India. Let us see the next festival what we have. Yes, the Gurpurab festival is celebrated by the Sikh community. This is supposed to be to worship the Guru, that is Guru Nanak. And on this day, all the people of the Sikh community, they go to the Gurdwara, they offer prayers, they also have Prabhat Feri in the morning. They all go around and they try to help out the people. And they also have langars in the evening, langar in which the free food is given to all the people who come in the Gurdwara. Food in huge quantity is made and it is distributed to the people all over, whoever is coming to the Gurdwara. So all this is done on this Gurpurab day or the Guru Nanak Jayanti. It is celebrated in the honor of remembrance of Sikh Guru. Now comes the festival of Christmas. Now Christmas marks the birth of Jesus Christ. And on this day, the people of the Christian community, they decorate the Christmas trees. They make all beautiful delicacies and delicious ones. And they all have party. Yes, we all love to have the Christmas party, no? And they all party in the evening. And yes, the different gifts are given to them by the family members, by the relatives and all the friends. And Santa is supposed to come on this day and surprise the children with the different gifts for all the good children. That is why we behave well throughout the year. So that in the month of December, when Santa comes, he gives gifts to all of us. And yes, like all of us, even these people, you know, during the festival, all visit our, yes, we all like to the temples or mosque or gurdwara and church for a special prayer in front of God. Christians, they go to the church and the festivals. Other than these, there are many more festivals celebrated by the Indians. Now, Didi said there are so many other festivals celebrated by Indians. Now, let us see whether all the children are satisfied by that or not. Oh, yes. Here comes one more chutki. Wow, Didi. That is why we get to taste so many delicacies, which are a speciality of each festival. Oh, how much I love being an Indian, just like me. Even I love being an Indian because we get to know so many festivals and get to eat so many delicacies brought by our different friends during their own festivals. Now, one more friend of Billu has come in the end. Now, what he has to tell us? He says, yes, but in the excitement, don't forget that in spite of all these varied cultures and traditions, we all stay together as Indians. That is what binds us together. So, my India, land of festival. Every day is like a carnival with lots of gifts and sweets, new dress and lighted streets. Diwali, Ganesh Chaturthi and Eid. Gudi Padwa, Holi and Christmas. Ek Bharat? Yes. Shresht Bharat. We are Ek Bharat. Shresht Bharat. Now with this end, we come to an end of this presentation. And I'm sure now that all of you know about all the different festivals that are celebrated in our country. Now, because you all were very good children, I'm going to explain you something more about the festivals. You know what? All our festivals have got some story attached to them. Correct? They have got some stories attached to them. And they have, all the festivals are a story of some sacrifice or someone's courageous deeds or some good deeds done by the people. For that, we celebrate these festivals. Now, one such festival we celebrate. And what is the story behind that? Let me tell you in short. Now, what I'm going to show you is a story. Everyone will look at the pictures that I have very carefully. Now, this is King Hiranyakashyap. Now, King Hiranyakashyap was a very mighty ruler. And he was ruling all over his kingdom. And he got a blessing from Lord Vishnu that no one can ever kill you, which made him very proudy. And because of that, he started troubling all the people of his kingdom. But he had one son called Prahlad. And Prahlad was a great devotee of Lord Vishnu. And he said that, I am not going to consider you as God. He forced everyone to worship him. I am the God, you will worship me. But Prahlad said, no, father, I will worship Lord Vishnu because he is the God. You are a king, you are my father, but you are not a God. So what did he do? Because he thought that because of him, there are so many other people who will come and they will also try to deny that I am their God. So what he did, he tried to get his own son killed. And he told all his soldiers to try different methods to kill him. So sometime one day he threw him in front of the snake. And immediately he started worshipping Lord Vishnu and started chanting Om Vasudevaya Namaha, Om Vasudevaya Namaha. And immediately Lord Vishnu came and saved him. Then what his father did, you know? He threw him from the mountain. Can you imagine? Yes, he made his soldiers throw him from the mountain, and again Lord Vishnu came and he saved him. Now Hiranyakashipu was very much angry, and he made him, he sent all his soldiers to kill him. But the soldiers were also not able to kill him because Lord Vishnu came and saved him. Now he was so tired, he went to his sister named Holika. And you know, Holika had got a blessing that the fire will not harm her. So she said, brother, you don't worry. I am there. I am going to help you out. And she said, you just burn a fire and I am going to sit with Prahlad in that fire. And you know that I will never, I want a boon. That fire will not harm me. So what she did, you know, she took Prahlad and she sat in the fire. But you know, to her surprise, what happened? She started burning and she started screaming. And Prahlad was unharmed. Nothing happened to him because he had the blessing of Lord Vishnu. That is why if we worship God from pure heart and soul, he'll always come to help us. And that day onwards, we celebrate that particular day as Holi. You know that in the Holi also, previous day of the colors, that is on the Holika Dahan day, we have this bonfire where mama and takes you so that we can throw all the things in the fire and celebrate, because this is the day when we, in this fire, we throw all the evil. Sare buri cheezo ko isme hum fek dete hain. We burn all the bad and we try to restore the good. So like that, that is why we celebrate Holi every year as a mark of respect for Prahlad. So like that only all the festivals have got different stories attached to them. Now other than the festivals which I showed you just now, there are many more festivals which are celebrated in our country. One such festival is Lohri. You know, Lohri is celebrated by the Sikh community. It is usually celebrated in the end of winter season just to show that they have got a good harvest. And in the evening, they burn the bonfire. And they respect, yes, they burn the bonfire at the Lohri and they pray to the god, to the sun god, that please keep our planet warm and let our crops grow. Now, the same festival is celebrated in different states in by different names. Like we celebrated as Makar Sankranti in our Maharashtra, and in the North India on this particular day, the people, they take a holy dip in the water. They go in the water and they offer prayer to the sun god. They take a holy dip in the water. Then in Gujarat, it is celebrated as a Uttarayan or the kite flying festival. And the International Kite Flying Festival is a highlight of that particular day. And in the North India, sorry, in the South, it's in Tamil Nadu, it is celebrated as Pongal, when the women, they make beautiful rangolis in front of their houses and they celebrate this by making pongal, or the dish which is made of the rice, which is the first harvest. So this is basically a harvest festival. Then next we have got the festival of Gokulashtami. Correct, we do this, the Janmashtami festival, too. Mark the importance of, or to celebrate the birthday of Lord Krishna. And you know, Lord Krishna, he used to love eating butter, and he used to do that by breaking all the pots. And that is why to imitate him, we make this human pyramids and we break the pot on the next day, that is the Gokulashtami. Then we have the festival of Mahavir Jayanti. Correct, Mahavir Jayanti celebrates the birth of Mahavira, a contemporary of Buddha and the 24th or the last sage. Buddha Purnima, Gautam Buddha. This is supposed to be the birthday of Siddharth Gautam. And every day, a very important day for the Buddhist community. And they celebrate this day as the Buddha Purnima day. Parsi New Year, celebrated by the Parsis, also known as the Navroz. And on this day, they go to the fire temple, they wear new clothes, go to the temple and they prepare various delicacies and have celebrated by wishing each other a happy Navroz or a happy New Year. This is supposed to be the first day of the beginning of the Iranian calendar. Then, our very favorite and the very own Raksha Bandhan. We have a very interesting story behind Raksha Bandhan also. When we have time next time, I'll explain you. Now, Raksha Bandhan is a day when the sister ties Rakhi on the wrist of the brother and he promises to save her, to protect her. Raksha means to protect. And that is why we celebrate this every year. Sister ties Rakhi, brother gives gifts. And nowadays, you know, the sisters are giving a special Rakhi to the brother. Stay home, stay safe, Rakhi. So that the brother does not go out purchasing gift for her. So she says that you stay at home and that is the greatest gift for me. And now, all the festivals when I have together, what you can do, you can make festivals like this only. Make a proper cover for it. And we can punch it and we can make a festival album. Correct. We can make a festival album for ourselves. And you can decorate it in a very nice way. We can punch it from here and we can make our own festival album. So this is the activity which all my kids are going to do after the lesson is over. Now, as I had promised, a game in the end. Now, I know we are running short of time. Just a very quick game we are going to have in which I'm going to show you certain eatables and you're going to tell me what comes to your mind when you see this eatables. Tilgur, correct. This reminds you of Makar Sankranti. The beautiful and the very delicious cake and the pastries. They remind us of which festival? Correct. I used to go to my friend's house every year for this. During the Christmas. Yes, for the Christmas party. Then, my favorite and everyone's favorite, Modak. Modak is something which all love to have. During which festival Mama makes this? Correct. Mama makes this during the Ganesh festival, Ganesh Chaturthi. This is favorite, you know, and my favorite as well. Now, this is a karanji or gujia. We make it during the Diwali also, but the North Indians, they make it during the Holi. This is a special dish that they prepare during the Holi. Now, my very favorite snacks. During which festival does Mama make this? Correct! Mama makes all these snacks during the Diwali festival. I am just waiting for Diwali festival so that so many things we can keep on munching throughout the day. Now, yes, my favorite chalebi. Chalebi and fafda. When do we have this? Yes, Mama brings it during which festival? The festival of Dasera. So, these are, and here comes the very nice bowl of sevaiya. During the Eid festival, Mama makes the sevaiya as a special delicacy. So, you see, in our Indian festivals, we don't have, we not only celebrate it in so many ways by with the help of colors, crackers, and so many things, but we also like it because of the different delicacies, different food items which are prepared during these festivals. So now we have learned about the different festivals and how they are celebrated in our country. And I'm sure all of you are very much clear about these. Now because you all told me all the answers correct, I request all the mamas to please prepare these delicacies one by one and give to all the children because they are very good children. They are staying at home and not troubling anyone and being good students as well. And the festival album which you all have to make, right? You can draw pictures and you can collect information about all of them and you can make a album of your own. So thank you for being a very good children, a very good class. And we are done for the day, children. Bye. See you in the next class. Thank you.